Bear on Long Island after a school bus with young children on board flipped over after colliding with a car. CBS 2's Jennifer McLogan reports from Central Islip.
The children, all 4, 5, and 6 years old, were on their way to a special class in Central Islip when their mini school bus collided with a sedan, careened off Islip Avenue, flipping and rolling over a fence into the yard of a Locust Street home. Chief Medic Scott Crosby.
If it wasn't for the matron and the school bus driver making sure that the kids were strapped in, I'm not sure what it could have been. Could have been 10 times worse.
The matron and bus driver made sure the children were out and safe, said homeowners who came running just before 11:30 a.m.
Tell me more about the children.
No, they were all good. They were all in shock. I was trying to talk to them, but they were all in shock.
The 7 kindergartners were taken by ambulance as a precaution to area hospitals, escorted by Suffolk school officials.
Being protected in the seatbelts, it probably made a big difference in preventing any serious harm.
Doctors at Southside Hospital and here at Good Samaritan remarked at how calm and composed the young victims appeared.
Children are very resilient in terms of trauma.
At the scene, investigators tried to recreate the accident. Colleagues of the school bus driver claimed the sedan blew a stop sign.
We have to correct the mistake of others. As a school bus drivers, sometimes it's impossible.
There was no way for the bus to avoid the car, she said. Others offered praise of first responders. Seatbelt advocates renewed calls to expand laws to keep all young children in safety seats, car seats, and belted in back seats. From Central Islip, Long Island, Jennifer McLogan, CBS 2 News.
The bus matron and the school bus driver, along with the 2 occupants of the car, were admitted to the hospital. All the children were treated at the hospital and released.